Hey everyone, you're here with Mark Bowell of PerfectGardens.com. So we got a great question from one of our YouTubers, J&K Triple. He's wondering, how often do we change the water in our aeroponic cloner? So if you haven't checked out our other video, Three Secrets to Getting Clones with the Aeroponic Cloner, I would highly recommend to check that video out, because a number of the things I discuss here will be in review for that video. Although, just to answer your question, I would say that I would recommend for you to swap out your water once you replace the same amount of water that you originally put in your reservoir. So let's say you have a 25 cloner site, whatever, and your reservoir is 3 gallons. Well, if you have needed to top off your water, 3 gallons of water before you got any roots, or before you got all the clones you wanted to get out of your aeroponic cloner, then I would recommend at that point to go ahead and stop and clean out the bottom of your reservoir. 100% just do a nice little quick thorough swap out and then get them back with fresh plants or fresh water again. That's just the blanket answer. Like right there, if you replace the amount of water that is in your reservoir, you should probably just give a fresh batch again because of residue or bacterial buildup or anything along those lines. Okay, so you have to remember though that these are clones. These plants are not going to be taking up a large amount of water. So if you do need to go through a reservoir change, I would recommend probably looking to see if there's any leaks in your reservoir system. Maybe you're not putting enough water in your reservoir initially. And also, you might also be running into some type of Pythium already going on, because you should be getting roots fairly quickly. And right when you're getting roots, you should be transplanting them. Right when you see the nubs come out of the root, maybe give it another day or two, but then you're transplanting fairly quickly because you don't want a large like stream of roots just coming down. Because when you have really long roots and you transplant them, what happens to the roots? You kind of start to put them in a spiral position, and that's not good. So for me personally, right when I see the nubs begin to come out of the roots, I transplant within a day or two. I normally begin to see nubs come out by the 4th or 5th day. The only reason why I don't see those nubs come out of the stalk of the root or the stalk of the stem is because maybe the temperature of my water is off, or I'm just have bad clones, or I just have clones that aren't rooting very well. And then you kind of have to go through the mental thought process of, do you really want plants that are not going to be producing roots very quickly? And are you really going to be wanting to deal with plants that are kind of struggling? If you're going to be dealing with plants that are struggling in the beginning, you're going to be dealing with a finicky plant all the way through your grow. And master grower tip number one, if it's a frustration to you, get rid of it. There's a saying that the squeaky wheel gets the grease. And normally, the squeaky wheel is normally not the one that deserves your energy. And what I mean by that is, being the squeaky wheel, it's either the customer that's calling you and annoying you and they're getting all the attention but they're not buying anything, or the plant that is sickly and you feel you have to nurse it back to health because you don't want to get rid of it, but then all your other plants end up getting sick because they're being neglected. I'm going to go back over to the temperature of the water. Temperature of the water plays a huge factor. If it gets above 60, maybe 62 degrees, you're going to start running into some issues and you're going to be slowing down root production. In addition to this, if you're using a product called Drops of Balance, which I talk about this all the time, Drops of Balance will actually keep your water clean until the minerals are used up. It's a very interesting product. A lot of people talk about stagnated water, and the reason why stagnated water goes bad is because either a lack of minerals in the water, and then there's VOCs, volatile organic compounds, from plastic leaching in, bacteria maybe that was contaminated the container that you're using, and then before you know it, water that you have stored begins to go bad. That's why it has to stay aerated or you have to have iodine tablets or just things along those lines to clean up your water again. If you use Drops of Balance to clean your water and then just put it on the shelf like a 1 gallon container, it's going to stay clean indefinitely or until the minerals are used up. So I'll give you an example. You clean a gallon of water in a plastic container and you put it in a cold, cool environment. Water is going to be good forever or until minerals are used up. You put that plastic container in an area of hot or where the sun's beating down on it. Well, the plastics are going to release volatile organic compounds. And then because toxins are being released back into the water, the minerals are being used up. And then the water can become bad over time because the minerals are constantly converting volatile organic compound back to sulfated minerals. It's basically the same situation here. If you're using Drops of Balance in your water reservoir or using a hydrogen peroxide product or even using both, because if you use hydrogen peroxide, it's not going to make Drops of Balance inert because Drops of Balance is trace minerals and you're oxidizing the water with peroxide with cleaning out. So both procedures would be just fine using it. If you wanted to throw in the peroxide to neutralize any bacterial growth in your reservoir, then add in Drops of Balance to make sure your water stays clean. Then step three is to make sure your reservoir is staying cool. And how do you do that? Make sure to check out the other video, but those three areas where temperature comes from is normally from your ambient air in your room, the light that you're using, and the water pump, which the other video I talked to you about, I go into depth about how to control temperature and various aspects in your cloner. So I hope I answered your question. How often do you want to change your water reservoir? I personally would change my water reservoir if I wasn't using Drops of Balance, if I wasn't using a hydrogen peroxide product, and if I wasn't totally disciplined on my water temperature. I will do a full reservoir change once I replaced the amount of water that's already was in my water reservoir. I do know some growers will even, once they replace half the container, they do a water reservoir as well. So once again, you have to comprehend how meticulous you want to be in your grow room. And the more things you have less control over in your grow room, the more problems you're going to be running into. So I hope this video was helpful on understanding how to use your aeroponic cloners a little bit more. If you have not checked out our aeroponic cloners, please scroll down and check out our description below. We have links to all of our aeroponic cloners at perfectgardens.com. Please like, share, and subscribe. Have a great grow, everyone.